to Cookstown, Pennsylvania, in the east of the state, came the baby Keith Haring in 1958. He tried art school in Pittsburgh, but he didn't stay long. They taught how things were done right, except to him that felt wrong. He was gay, he was cool, he wanted sex, drugs, and art. He came to New York for school, where real adventures could start. He studied words and abstractions, funky patterns and lines. He wanted raw interaction, he saw a language in signs. In small underground clubs, he organized crazy shows, parties where everyone's welcome, art nights where anything goes. He loved the world of graffiti, where being seen was essential. He first tried ways to repeat it, using flyers or a stencil. The 1980 Times Square show was an art melting pot of Bronx and Brooklyn and Soho, young Keith and young Basquiat. Now Keith's art was reaching into clear lines and forms, where little people and creatures came in mysterious swarms. In 81 in New York, where subway ads were untaken, Keith started using white chalk to draw these forms he'd been making. And he made hundreds of drawings till the whole city could see him. And art for all kinds of people, not just inside a museum. Then he got to do animations on the big sign in Times Square. Keith's figures from the train stations were catching on everywhere. By 82, folks were paying just for his paintings from home. Galleries asked to display him, where famous artists were shown. And when his galleries opened, these were exciting events, because from Warhol to breakdancers were all Keith's fans and his friends. And as his work spread all over through 1983, up shot this upstart from nowhere to art world celebrity. Now in a 4-year relationship with big money and press, Keith's hard work and sweet nature were not changed by success. And from the old Berlin Wall to every sculpture and kid, from giant murals to small, he'd never sketch what he did. But his problem with fame was his art couldn't stay free. Now if he drew on the train, it got stolen instantly. So in 1986, he launched his pop shop art stores to keep his art in the public, not behind gallery doors. Also, unlike normal artists, Keith used brave, simple text to speak out on AIDS and apartheid and crack and safe sex. But no one knew about safety back when Keith had been young. AIDS took him in 1990 when he was just 31. Keith's explosive short lifetime and bold, generous heart speak like an infinite fountain from some deep wellspring of art.